and welcome to Prudent Media News. First, we take a look at the headlines. Ruling MLAs from mining belt plead to restore legal mining operations soon, support CM's decision but anxious about delay. Supreme Court's landmark judgment says that High Court judge should be made State Information Commissioner. Verdict affects Goa State Information Commission. Dr. Pradeep Padwal resigns from his post. Congress demands Supreme Court monitor panel to probe illegal mining, says no faith in state government, welcomes MoEF's decision to suspend environment clearances. Goa University decide to amend their sports policy, students' participation in local sports associations to be recognized for grace marks, amendment likely to come in force from next academic year. And Surinder Amarnath forms a part of Moroccan's humble cricket beginning. Goa may tour Morocco for cricket tour, says GCA's chief consultant coach. Diesel prices have been raised and restrictions have been imposed on subsidized LPG cylinders. After the price hike of 5 rupees per litre, diesel will now cost rupees 48 and 20 paisa in Goa. Restrictions have been imposed on subsidized LPG cylinders procurement. LPG cylinders have been capped at 6 per family for a year.
The Cabinet Committee on Political Affairs on Thursday decided to hike the diesel price by rupees 5 per litre. The diesel price hike will be effective from Thursday midnight onwards. But there is no increase in the prices of petrol and kerosene. However, restrictions have been imposed on LPG subsidy and LPG cylinders have been kept at 6 per family a year. Remaining cylinders have to be procured at market rate. Meanwhile, opposition parties have criticized central government over this decision and have planned for nationwide agitation from 17 September. Bureau report, Prudent Media.
Chief Minister has hit out at Union Minister for Environment and Forest, Jayanti Natarajan. He claimed that environment clearances of mines are not suspended. He called Union Minister's speech a political gimmick. He said, Natarajan has admitted that her ministry issued bogus and illegal environment clearances. He demanded action against her own ministry officials.
I think yesterday's event, though it was a political reaction, because even now, up till now, there is no suspension order issued. There is nothing on the website of Ministry of Environment. When we tried to contact, all officers are in meetings. It was a political reaction immediately, not this. Jayanti Natarajan eta hanga natka karta, show karta hanga basun. It was a show before an audience only to show them that they are doing something. Why they had Shah Commission for 6 months? Why didn't they act before I acted? Because I acted, they are under pressure now to show, to cover their tracks.
Natarajan, while by announcing suspension of ECs, has herself indirectly admitted that environmental clearances were given to mines illegally. Parikar dared Natarajan to initiate criminal inquiry against MoEF officials.
Jayanti Natarajan should initiate criminal proceedings against her environment ministry officials, who has even gone to the extent of giving environment clearance for a non-existing lease. I will be writing to Prime Minister that he should tune down his ministry properly. Within 1 month, I suspended Director Mines. Before, once the Shah Commission report came into picture, we suspended 7 officials, even though their names are not mentioned. Here is a case, there are more like this, huh? Where name of the official is mentioned by Shah. What action Jayanti Natarajan has taken?
BJP has demanded that Congress MLA Digambar Kamath should resign as a MLA and Congress should apologize to Goans for the mining fraud.
Congress should tender an unqualified apology to the people of Goa for leading us to the mess which today Goa finds into. Thirdly, we demand that Mr. Digambar Kamath resign. Therefore, Mr. Digambar Kamath is directly responsible for this mess as a Minister of Mines. And therefore, he should immediately resign from the Goa Legislative Assembly.
Senior reporter Lokik Shilkar, Avinash Joshi with video journalist Devendra Gaonkar and Omkar Falari for Prudent Media.
Ruling MLAs from the mining belt are of the opinion that government should complete verification of mines quickly and restart legal mining. They are with CM's decision. Being from the mining belt, CM had taken them into confidence before ordering mines closure. But they are anxious following the bitter tussle between state and the centre.
मनोहर भाई वो इमिडिएटली एक्ट जाले चार रिपोर्टाचे बाकीची जो गजाली कोणी पण सेंटरान मिटरान डिसिजन घेऊपाचे केल्या त्यो मागे आफ्टर थॉट असा आणि योग्य पद्धतीन तेगे हाताळपाची जी किती पण शैली असा त्या पद्धतीन त्या पुढे जर केले जाईल तर व्यवस्थित सामके सिस्टमॅटिकली कोणाक प्रॉब्लेम जायनासतना हो इश्यू चलता
70% ऑफ द पॉप्युलेशन डायरेक्टली मायनिंगला डिपेंड असा आणि जर तर मायनिंग चालू जायना आमचे हे वाटरान खुबश्यो लोकांच्यो प्रॉब्लम जातल्यो इन्स्टॉलमेंट भरपाक शकना आनी खुबशे त्रास जातले लोकांक आमी सरकारा कडेन एज रुलींग MLA आमी सरकारा कडेन परत मागणी आसतली की मायनींग ते लिगल मायनींग आसा ते एटलीस्ट चालू करपाक दिवचे
ह्या एकांनी जी कारवाय करपाक जाय त्या संदर्भातलो विशय जो आसा की गव्हर्मेंटान आमच्या मुख्यमंत्री आसा की ज्यो कांय खाणी आसा ती कांय दिसा पुरते सगळ्या कडेन जे उलोवन आसा डिस्कस करून आसा तो विषय फुडल्या कांय दिसांनंतर मायनी सुरू जातल्यो त्यामुळे मायनी संपत बंद जातल्यो बंद करपाचें धोरण आमच्या सरकारान
जेन्ना डिसिजन घेता तुमी कॉन्फिडन्सा बी घेतले तुमकां मिनिस्टरां
बी मिनिस्टरांक आमकां मिनिस्टरांक कॉन्फिडन्स किंवा आमदारांक कॉन्फिडन्स घेवनूच हो विषय
एनवायरमेंटाक डॅमेज करपाक जायना नेचर आमचो बिगडपाक जायना शेती शेतकऱ्यांक लॉस जावपाक जायना आनी लोकांक त्रास जावपाक जायना ह्या दृश्टिकोनांतल्यान जर 1-2 महिने हातूंत भितर रेगुलरायज करपाक बरे शिस्त हाडपा खातीर जर प्रयत्न केले जर जायत इट इज अ वेलकम स्टेप पूण नॉट बियॉन्ड 2 मंथ्स 2 महिने आनीक जर बंद जाले जर जायत हांगच्या बँकांची परिस्थिती नाजूक जातली जेन्ना शाह कमिशन रिपोर्ट जेन्ना तांचेर डायरेक्टली ह्या हाजेर बोट दवरता तेन्ना म्हाका दिसता की सरकारान ताजेर ताबडतोब एक्ट जावप गरजेचें आसा ना जर जायत सरकार मायनींग फेवर करता असो कितें संभ्रम जावपाक शकता म्हूण एखादे वेळ तात्काळ डिसिजन घेतले MLA कॉन्फिडन्साक तशें घेवपाक म्हाका दिसता मनोहर भाई टायम मेळना
आर रिपोर्टर फ्रॉम सांगेम मयूर नायक
In a landmark judgment, the Supreme Court has ordered that a current or former High Court judge should be made the State Information Commissioner. One of the 2 members of each bench will have to be with legal background. Following this judgment, State Information Commissioner of Goa, Dr. Pradeep Padwal, has resigned from his post.
Supreme Court ruling on Thursday will change how RTI machinery information commissions in states and at the centre will work. The court passed its verdict on a petition filed by Namit Sharma. Petitioner said, that since the work of the CIC under the RTI Act is mainly connected with the law, members in the transparency panel should have judicial background. Apex Court also said that all information commissions will have to include members with legal background and wants all of them to work with 2-member benches. Government had opposed the petition contending that it could not be made mandatory and that the members should have judicial background. The Central Information Commission says it is studying the order to figure out its implications. Currently, state information commissioners are mostly former bureaucrats. The verdict, if enforced, will definitely have an effect on functioning of state information commissioners, as the state information commissioner has to be a high court judge. Bureau report, Prudent Media.
It's time now for a short break. Stay tuned.